Buddhang Saranam Gacchami.
The Sakyamuni Buddha represents the highest ideal that a human being can attain. He was a perfectly enlightened being. In order to achieve this fully awakened state, he had to toil and perfect himself over incalculable lifetimes. His journey to Buddhahood began when he was born as an ascetic named Sumedha. An encounter with the previous Buddha named Dipankara gave rise to a strong aspiration in Sumedha's mind to attain Buddhahood himself. When Sumedha saw that Dipankara Buddha was about to walk through a patch of mud, he bent down and spread his hair for Dipankara Buddha to walk over so that his feet did not get soiled. Dipankara Buddha then made a prophecy that Sumedha would indeed become a future Buddha by the name of Gautama. The stories describing the journey of the Bodhisattva towards Buddhahood are called the Jatakas. They were narrated by the Buddha himself to the disciples to teach them the Dhamma. These stories have inspired Buddhists across Asia and have been depicted in Buddhist art from ancient times. Today we will learn the story of the Mahakapi Jataka. The Mahakapi Jataka is a story of immense grit and gumption. It is also a story of selfless leadership. A true leader is a visionary and a courageous individual, always ready to make the greatest of sacrifices for his followers. The Mahakapi Jataka is that story of a courageous leader. Once upon a time, the Bodhisattva was born as a great monkey, a valiant leader of 80,000 monkeys on the banks of the mighty Ganges. On finding that his tribe is in great danger because of an attack by the king's army, he decides to make a bridge of his own body for the monkeys to climb upon. Each of the 80,000 monkeys climb upon the great monkey's body and are saved because of him. One jealous monkey from the tribe, envious of the great monkey, tries to kill him, but ends up gravely injuring him instead. The king, who watches the entire scene unfolding before his eyes, is astounded at the great monkey's dedication and compassion towards his subjects. He becomes deeply repentant of what he has done and summons his soldiers to save the great monkey, but it is too late. In his last moments on his deathbed, the great monkey teaches the king the qualities of a true leader and how, despite all hurdles, for a king, the welfare of his subjects is at most even more than his own life. When the great monkey dies, the king pays homage to his relics and abides by the teachings of selflessness and generosity till the very end of his life. The Mahakapi Jataka is depicted through art in three places across India: Bharut, Sanchi, and the Ajanta Caves. The Bharut stupa and sculptures found in the village of Bharut in Madhya Pradesh represent some of the earliest examples of Indian art and architecture, that is, in the 2nd century BCE. The site was excavated by the British civil servant Alexander Cunningham in 1874. This rounded relief is one of the most stunning representations of the Mahakapi Jataka in art at the Bharut Stupa. It is in the form of a medallion and it depicts multiple scenes from the Mahakapi Jataka. We see the river Ganges abundant with fish and two trees on either side of the river. The great monkey, having fastened his ankle to the tree on the left, clutches firmly onto the branches of the tree on the right, making his body a bridge for the monkeys to safely tread upon. In the top half of the relief, the monkeys are shown moving from the tree on the right to the one on the left, climbing the body of the Bodhisattva. We also see next to the river two men holding a piece of fabric to rescue the injured monkey. In another scene, we see the king and the great monkey sitting across each other, wherein the great monkey teaches righteousness to the king. The Mahakapi Jataka is the centerpiece of one of the railings of the Bharut Stupa. At present, this roundel relief is housed in the Indian Museum, Kolkata. Sachi is a complex of ancient Buddhist stone structures in the state of Madhya Pradesh. It is an extremely important monument and was originally commissioned in the 3rd century BC by Ashoka the Great to house the relics of the Buddha. The original construction work of this stupa was overseen by Ashoka, whose wife Devi was the daughter of a merchant of a nearby town called Vidisha. Sachi was also her birthplace as well as the venue of her and Ashoka's wedding. In this relief at Sachi from the 1st century BCE, we see the river Ganges full of lively fish, flanked by two trees on either side. In the topmost part of the panel, we see the great monkey making his body into a bridge to rescue his tribe. Below this, we see the great monkey instructing the king on the values of righteous leadership. Further down, we see the king's archer pointing his bow and arrow to shoot the bodhisattva. To the left of this, we see the king riding on a horseback with a parasol. At the very bottom of the panel, we see attendants and musicians depicting the royal entourage of the king. The Ajanta caves are about 30 rock-cut caves dating from the 2nd century BCE to 480 CE in the Aurangabad district of Maharashtra. They are the finest surviving examples of Buddhist paintings, art and architecture which depict emotions, postures and gestures through expressive paintings and carved sculptures unique to Ajanta. The Ajanta Caves are also categorized as a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1983 and is a protected monument. In this painting at cave number 17 at the Ajanta Caves, we see the great monkey lying injured on his deathbed while the king and the attendants tend to him in his last moments. Truly, the Mahakapi Jataka teaches us the value of selfless love, great sacrifice and leadership. It is a story of ideal leadership very relevant to modern times with much to imbibe from. Throughout the 547 Jataka stories, we find gems of wisdom. Each story in its ornate glory, teaching us the value of living the ethical life, doing good for others and for oneself. Even today, the Jatakas live fresh in our hearts, as they have lived in the past and will probably into the future, arousing and kindling our true inner goodness. Today, in times of great despair, disease and suffering, Jataka stories hold the promise of hope, optimism and peace for all the people of the world, irrespective of color, race and religion.